I want you to still be able to eat. This is, we're not quite ready to start with the panel. I just thought I'd do some little housekeeping, little things like that. We're going to be here together until 3. This first part is for you to get to know and meet people at your table. And if you don't like them, change tables. Because one of the things we hear is that it's very important to meet your peers, meet other certificates, and kind of see what happens there. I thought I would like to start out by recognizing some people that are here, just to give you an idea. But do you need 5 more minutes to eat? Where are you? I mean, tell me. Need 5? You've been asked for 5, I'm going to check back in at 5. Bye. You know, if you're down at the table, you can still choose. The panelists can't choose. So, I promise that I want to have the panelists not choose. Make those kind of changes. Let me just kind of like start out with some little housekeeping and some recognition and kind of like what we're doing here. First of all, some of you may remember that we actually have a committee that has oversight of this particular program. They call the Certification Governance Committee, and we have some of the members here. So I'd like to ask Andrea Moore if you would stand, Carolyn Judge, Vince Arroyo, he's a member of it. Is Don Stepich here? Is Don Kirky here? Please stand. Okay. Charlotte, are you here? Have you had to leave? I know she's been catching a plane. There she is in the back. And I got Andrea. I know that we're missing Char. I believe Rob had to leave. Rob Fouché, he's gone. Okay. Am I missing anybody else from the group? I'm missing Stepich in the room, and I'm missing Fouché, and I'm missing Char. Oh, and Don, Patlin. Okay, David, wave your hand. David Padley is the U.S. Coast Guard. He's a boatswain, and he is our most recent CPT. Thank you very, very much. Right. And how many in the room are actually reviewers of applications? Would you stand for me? Come on. We're still on reviewers. One of my reviewers came up and talked about the fact she hadn't been to a conference in a number of years and that she's really liking the CPT update, and that got her to come back. She felt the CPT update gave her a sense of feeling of community, so we like some other people liking the update. If you really want me to do anything different with that little update, please tell me. Otherwise, you're going to be subjected to only my hallucinations about what it is I think you need to know and what I want to share. But I really enjoy putting that together every month, and I really like to feature you. We have some, you have peers who are really doing great work, writing books, getting other awards, and what have you, doing some exciting kind of stuff. And we sometimes have some critical dialogue about things. I thought I would write up a little bit of Irana's presentation yesterday. She's with Microsoft, talking about, I had met with the advocates about how to get to the C-suite, and I thought I would build on what she said. I'll be sharing that or something like that. By the way, who in the room is among our most recent, this year's class of CPTs? I know David is. Who else here is our newbie? Come on, don't just raise your hand, stand up. We really do welcome you, and we think that's great. By the way, we do have some guests with us today who are not CPTs, and one of those is Deb Page, who's actually our closing keynoter. And I wanted you to know that Deb is actually a candidate for the CPT. So we're going to go with you. That are not in the room. Don't worry. We will keep all that a secret or something like that. Do we have any CPTs in the room who are not from the United States proper? Do we have some of those other ones? Yeah, so that's a Canadian back there. We have a South African. Come on, stand up. Come on. It won't hurt. It helps with digestion. Stand up. The next most recent one, David was the very last one, but the gentleman before him is from Poland. And it just put us in a whole new country. That's why we're up to 25 countries. So we're now in Poland. I thought that was very, very nice. Do we have anybody in here who represents some of our academic partners? How about Boise? Do we have any Boiseites here? How about some Capellaites? Do we have any Capellaites in the room? Oh, come on. Do we have any of those Indianaites? Come on. And how about, I don't think we have any St. Clouders here. We do have a St. Clouder visiting. We have any St. Clouder. How about San Diego State? Do we have any more San Diego State? Pardon me? Well, wasn't real clear, Dawn, whether I was picking the long or something like that. So, if you feel deep affiliation, you can still stand. Right? Something like that. Well, the other thing is that, before I go any further, I really want to make it a point just to say, your lunch is because we have sponsors. And it was really kind of funny because we got enough money to buy chips. I don't want any waste on this table. I want you to know this is the most expensive lunch that you, simple but expensive lunch. So if you can't eat your potato chips, you're to save them and take them home for the squirrels. You can give them to the neighbor's kid, but there will be no waste at this lunch. I'm sorry. That's absolutely off limits. You should have received a little flyer, okay, on both sides. I was absolutely overwhelmed. We had 14 people. We had, I guess you could say, 11 people raise their hands and volunteer to be sponsors, and we had 3 chapters raise their hands. So those chapters have said, we will try to offset our chapter members' cost for lunch. So Atlanta, Chicago, and Denver were very gracious to do it. But we also had, some individuals on the back. Clara Carey, Clara, would you stand up? Okay, I don't, Jane Sinkup, she's with us. Joe Durso, unfortunately, due to the volcano, was stuck. Maybe we should save him a lunch. Maybe he bought a lunch. Well, do you think we could refrigerate it and save it for him? I don't think so. He's in Paris. He won't want this lunch. Okay, or something like that. Don Snyder is one of our. Come on, Don, stand up. Janice Goodheim is here. I saw Janice. Where'd you go? There she is. Very, very nice. Very nice. And on the front, we have some other members who have wanted their own companies recognized. You do like that's why you got the little red bags. That's Becky Harris. Becky, stand up. There she is. And Chuck O'Keefe, is Chuck with us? Oh, he just said it Monday. Okay, well, that's great. We'll take it. Something like that. Pat's here. Pat is actually in the new class, okay? I'd like you to know that when Pat got his CPT, he was promoted, he got a bonus, and he has a job opening, which he has posted. But he donated his bonus to the launch. How did I know? Wow. Jim Perry. I've seen Jim. There he is, back there. I hear him somewhere. He started his poem. We have Lynn Carney. Come on, stand up. Roger Addison. Get up. Out of here, everybody. Sit mine, I saw you somewhere. There you go. And I don't know, is Daryl with us or not? Okay, now I promised some of these people hugs. So Jane and Daryl got their hugs, I don't know. So and some people got stars. If I missed you on the star thing, let me know. I'll be happy to give you a star. And if I owe anybody a hug, I promise to hug. Now, I'll be working also with John Chen to get out a message about you in the Performance Express and the CPT up there. I applaud you for stepping up and continuing to our ability to get together, have lunch, network, and all those kinds of things. But again, there will be no waste. I want to be real clear about this, okay? If you know it, just take them home, right, and feed them to the squirrels, if nothing else. That's what I don't care about, something like that. Well, I'm going to give you a little update. I'm kind of reviewing this a little bit here. We have officially certified 1,104 CBTs. I have almost 130. I am real confident that I have 128 people in the pipeline. Those are candidates. Those are people who have paid for the designation but haven't completed the paperwork. And I'm expecting that paperwork in fairly, well, over the next couple of months or something like that. Some of you might have heard about the USAID deal. USAID is a major government agency. They're going to be letting some $200 million in contracts. And they wrote in the specification that to bid you had to be certified in HPT. Isn't that interesting? They use the famous unpopular initials, HPT. And I called them when I talked to them about that. We didn't drive that, they drove that. I said, well, how did you get here? And they said, well, we see a significant difference in our bidders who have the designation. Their work is more sustainable compared to the bidders and their work and that they put out. So part of this is our government trying to not just spend money that has a lasting effect, because they see themselves grinding out lots of money annually, and it's like redo, and not really looking at what it takes for sustainability. So I'm really excited about that. I will be in contact with them. That's opened some other doors to a number of other companies that were coming in and doing in-house programs, and I think it's going to lead to some other opportunities for us. We also are continuing to shape and influence curriculum. How many of you in the room are adjunct faculty? See the hands? There's a lot of you. Do we have any full-timers in the room? And we have a couple full-timers. Very good. Well, my point is, because we're in a position to begin to shape our curriculum, and so I'm very excited. I personally have been working with Purdue, Calumet, Franklin University, Grantham University, Roosevelt, Northeastern, okay? So we're trying very hard to shape that. Now, I know Boise and Capella, they're already done. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about new universities or universities newly discovering this discipline and developing curriculum around our standards. I think it's very exciting. The other thing I want to update has to do with our relationship with SHRM. Last year, one of our members was most gracious, and she helped us, as Alice Denninger. She helped us get our programs recognized for their certification. So if you are a member of SHRM, you have to get so many extra hours to maintain your certification. And a percentage of those have to be in what they call strategic subjects. What's interesting is that our programs qualify for strategic credit. But we have to do that. Not that. So one of my goals is to actually apply for SHRM for us to become an official recognizer of these kinds of programs. And I'm going to be drawing on Alice's help to fill out the paperwork or something like that. Real quickly, our industry teams, some of them are doing very well, some are struggling, some are still norming and storming. They're all different things over the map. But yesterday, you know, we had our industry team sessions, and I wanted you to know that the Admiral came, and the U.S. Coast Guard Admiral, and Bill Yeager was kind of gracious enough to host that. But you know what got him to the table? It was one of our panelists, our own Rear Admiral, Donald Crisp, retired, who was U.S. Navy. And when he heard another Admiral was going to be at the table, he decided maybe maybe at the table. So, but his final comment was, you know, we get more than we give. So we need, you know, I think that's very powerful. So we need people of that status to understand that affiliation with ISPI benefits them, and they benefit us. So I was really excited. I'm getting ready to tell you that I have been invited to actually visit a ship that's on the Michigan, Lake Michigan, and it's an ice cutter. And it's the new technology. It's the kind that goes up and crushes the ice rather than rams it. And I've been asked, so I'm going to do the tour, right? So I've got the word out that I love all those guys. We're going to see what happens. Now I'm going to talk about something a little bit different. I'm going to ask all of you to put CPT in your signature. I'm amazed at how many of us, our CBTs and our email addresses, we don't put it after our name. It's not on our business cards. It's not on our stationery. And then we want to know why nobody knows us. You are our marketing group. So I just ask you, think about it. You can certainly put your academic degrees. I'm not talking about that. I want you to really think hard about going back and putting the CBT on your signature. I'm asking for you to do that. I need you to spread the word. I need you to have the conversation. What's those numbers about? What's that mean? That's how we started. So think about it, because I'm always intrigued at the number of us who send me emails and the CBT doesn't appear anywhere in their signature. Also, you're going to be hearing from me soon because I have another request. You know, one of the things we get asked for are stories. Do you have examples in call centers? Do you have any examples of this stuff in healthcare? Do you have any examples of this stuff in the finance department? Do you have any examples of this stuff, you understand, field sales? Do you have any examples of this stuff? So I've been working with the help of Don, with her hand, Don, okay, and some other groups, and we've been testing out a template. I'm going to be asking you to repurpose your own application. I don't want to make it hard or something like that, but I'll be sending this out. I'm going to be asking you to dust off that application and retell your story. You get a choice about whether or not you want to name the company and keep that silent. You get a choice about if you want to give your own name, you can keep that silent, or you can toot your own horn. But I'll be asking you to list the industry and the function and some interesting things so that we can put in our new content management, knowledge management system, whatever we call it, so that people can search based on industry and function. So they can pull up and get some examples. Wouldn't that be nice? Right? And you get to populate.